One very common argument against smart home devices is that when network is down, those devices can't be used at all. It may seem like it to an outsider, but often that is not the case. While they are mostly controlled over a network using automations, smartphone apps, etc., they can still have offline functionality. In this video, I will share how you can add offline fallback functionality to your ESPHome project in case the network is down or Home Assistant server isn't available. For this project, I'm using the PCB I got from sponsor of this video, PCBWAY.com. They offer a famous $5 for 10 pieces of 10x10cm PCBs, but that's not all. You can order more advanced PCBs from them as well. And how about CNC milling, 3D printing and other manufacturing services? They got you covered. For all your prototyping needs, go check out their current pricing and services at PCBWAY.com. And to be clear, this ESPHome project detects when the connection is down and actually replaces the main action with different action to allow usage during connection issues. Project I made to demonstrate this feature is something I have wanted for a while. It's a smart doorbell that will turn into regular doorbell when Wi-Fi is down. And when everything is working, Wi-Fi is up and Home Assistant server is running, pressing the doorbell button will send information to Home Assistant. There I can freely configure different automations that should happen. Chime on smart speakers around the house, notification on TV screen, flashing light in music room, or other loud environment. Whatever is suitable based on sensors and other variables in Home Assistant system. But if the Home Assistant server is offline, these previously mentioned alarms are not available. As a fallback offline function, local chime will be activated using GPIO pin set as an output. Hardware side is very simple, but here are the connections. Button is connected between D1 and ground, internal pull-up is used. Chime will be connected to D2 pin, but in this demonstration I'm using LED as a more visual representation of the output pin. In the configuration I will also use D4 pin, but that is connected to built-in LED and doesn't need any external connections. This is just one example of what could be done with this feature. Next, I will show how I programmed this, so you can implement it in your own project the way you want. As usual, the beginning of the configuration is basically the same for each project. There are things like port setup, Wi-Fi settings, etc. First thing to configure is the button, which is binary sensor using GPIO platform. I like to use 100 millisecond delayed on and 500 millisecond delayed off filters on buttons for debouncing and such. Because this binary sensor component section doesn't have internal parameter set, this is enough to get the button information to Home Assistant. Binary sensor will show up in this device's device page and it can be used as trigger in Home Assistant's automations. For the fallback offline function, in this case local chime, I'll include on press section in this binary sensor section, and inside it I'm checking if API connected is not true. In that case, local chime will be turned on for a second after pressing the button. But when the API connected is true, when ESPHome device is added to Home Assistant will connect to ESPHome node using API, and another API connection could be active log session over Wi-Fi. I also wanted to have a visual indicator of connection status, so I wrote this interval component section. Every 5 seconds, this checks if any API client is connected, and if so, turn the built-in LED on, otherwise turn it off. The chime and LED outputs are just basic outputs using GPIO platform. This is one of those things that people have asked quite often. Like many other things, this was super simple to do with ESPHome once the correct information was found. I hope this video was useful to some of you. See you next video. Thanks. Bye.